Well, first of all, this is two different questions. General Dempsey went on to say he thought that Iran was a rational actor. I can't imagine why he would say that. And I just cannot imagine why he would have said it. The fact is, this is a dictator, Ahmadinejad, who has said he doesn't believe the Holocaust existed. This is a dictator who said he wants to eliminate Israel from the face of the earth. This is a dictator who said he wants to drive the United States out of the Middle East. I'm inclined to believe dictators. Now, I think that it's dangerous not to. If an Israeli prime minister, haunted by the history of the Holocaust, recognizing that three nuclear weapons is a Holocaust in Israel, if an Israeli prime minister calls me and says, I believe in the defense of my country, this goes back to a point that Congressman Paul raised that we probably disagree on. I do believe there are moments when you preempt. If you think a madman is about to have nuclear weapons and you think that madman is going to use those nuclear weapons, then you have an absolute moral obligation to defend the lives of your people by eliminating the capacity to get nuclear weapons.
Of Syria, Mr. Speaker, then Governor Romney, if you were president today, what would you do differently from this president tomorrow?
Well, look, the first thing I do across the board for the entire region is create a very dramatic American energy policy of opening up federal lands and opening up offshore drilling, replacing the EPA. The Iranians have been practicing closing the Straits of Hormuz, which has one out of every five barrels of oil in the world going through it. We have enough energy in the United States that we would be the largest producer of oil in the world by the end of this decade. We would be capable of saying to the Middle East, we frankly don't care what you do. The Chinese have a big problem because they ain't going to have any oil. But we would not have to be directly engaged. It's a very different question. But first of all, you got to set the stage, I think, here to not be afraid of what might happen in the region. Second, we clearly should have our allies, this is an old-fashioned word, we should have our allies covertly helping destroy the Assad regime. There are plenty of Arab-speaking groups that would be quite happy. There are lots of weapons available in the Middle East. And I agree with Senator Santorum's point. This is an administration which, as long as you're America's enemy, you're safe. You know, the only people you got to worry about is if you're an American ally.